celebrating 10 years of growth. This is CNN.
Welcome back. We're taking your calls on fighting crime and public housing. Our guests in Los Angeles, Ed Lawson, who thinks the drug war is a complete farce and ought to be called off. Vince Lane in Chicago, who's been using surprise raids in the Chicago housing projects. And Frank Keating of HUD, who wants to take away their leases and their stereos and everything else after he kicks them out of the projects. Let's go to Bentonville, Arkansas. You're on the air.
Yeah, I want to know. They keep saying that it's unconstitutional to do these raids, and I'd like to know from the man in Los Angeles exactly where does it say in the Constitution that it is illegal for the police to go in with probable cause and search and arrest anyone in an illegal activity, no matter where it is.
Go ahead, Ed.
Well, they're not saying what you just described is unconstitutional. What they are saying is that there's Fifth Amendment due process question, and that in some instances there's a question as to whether they have probable cause. So that's a Fourth Amendment question, and then secondly, again, a Fifth Amendment question.
But Ed, what Vince is doing in Chicago doesn't have any constitutional problem at all. He's been doing it and succeeding. Why aren't
Well, here again, I'm saying that what I'm saying you're looking at there. Here again, sir, I'm not saying I am dramatically against all of what he is doing, or even more so what Mr. Keating's doing. I'm saying it's irrelevant, sir. I'm saying what we are looking at is the leprosy colony syndrome. You cannot drive all the lepers out of the leper colony and then maintain you've cured leprosy. I'm not saying it's hideously evil. It has no impact on the war against drugs. It has a deteriorating effect on the constitutional guarantees for all of us. But that's my concern.
All right, Vince, tell him the impact it's having in Chicago.
No, I heard that at the beginning of the program. I'm saying that I can get you those kind of numbers for a week, for a day, for a year.
Ed,
but the same people who were dealing drugs that you understandably drove out of your housing project, they didn't go to heaven, sir. They're in someone else's community doing exactly the same thing. Give them a little time, they'll be back.
Vince? Look, what I want to say is that we talk about rights. Well, I let the residents in public housing cells, and what they say to me is that what we do by driving out the gangs and drug dealers is to return some of the rights to them that the gangs took from them 30 years ago. They have been without rights for 30 years, and they wholeheartedly endorse what we're doing, or else we wouldn't be doing it.
Okay, let's go to Tidewater, Virginia. You're on the air.
Yeah, I've got two questions for you, Frank Keating, and I want you to answer both questions because you sound like you're trying to get George Bush to break a very solemn campaign promise that he made regarding drugs. If George Bush, or the Bush administration, is going to keep its promise to put drug dealers in jail, why are you putting so much emphasis on taking their leases away? And then I have a second question.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, As I indicated at the start of the program, taking leases away is one of the numerous arrows in our quiver. There's only so much that HUD can do. We can evict people who deal in drugs, and we are doing that. We can seize public housing leases, which we're also doing. We can assist a Vince Lane and others around the country with Operation Clean Sweeps, which we're going to do also. We're not in the law enforcement business per se. We can't arrest people. We can certainly encourage law enforcement to help. But again, we are fundamentally responding to what the public housing tenants themselves want. And I want to mention one thing as a follow-up to what Vince was saying in Chicago. Jack Kemp and I visited Chicago a few months after the first of the clean sweeps. We were going down the elevator in that public housing project in Rockwell Gardens, and there was a lady and her child who got on the elevator. We were talking about the ACLU lawsuit, and the secretary turned to this woman, and he said, "Do you feel your rights have been violated?" And the woman said, not knowing who he was, "Mr., before they got rid of these people in this place, I didn't have any rights. I had to pay 25 cents for my daughter to get on the elevator to gang members. I had to sleep underneath the windowsill so that I wouldn't be hit by crossfire from bullets." I mean, what kind of living environment is that? Kemp is tired of it. Kemp wants the Vince Lanes of the world to help him, and he wants to help them to rid public housing of the drug dealers so that people who live in public housing can have a safe and a secure living environment.
New York City, you're on the air.
Yes, I used to live in a project, and it was wonderful. It was a middle-income project. The people there cared. They took care of everything. The parents taught the children how to take care of property. Some of the problems today in public housing is the parents no longer care. They let the kids go out, do graffiti on the walls. They break everything down. Also, to keep a place clean, there's plenty of soap and water. There's no excuse for that. And living with drug addicts is a horrible thing, and I'm glad they're getting the police to get them out. We need more of that.
Okay, Vince, this goes back to the point, Vince, I want to get back to. Now, it's a good idea, everybody agrees, getting these bums out, the gang members and the rest of them, but what about the traditional values that did seem to be there in the 1950s in a lot of poor housing projects, even poor, much poorer than they are by today's standards, but they're gone. How do you get those values back in if the people themselves don't have them?
Well, what we're going to do here, Pat, is we're going to bring working families back into public housing. In Chicago, we've deteriorated to the point where 80% of the people in public housing are single female heads of household on welfare. You cannot establish after three or four generations anything but what we have when kids, all they see around them is somebody waiting on a welfare check and a sister that's going to have her own babies at the age of 13 so she can get a public housing apartment and a welfare check, and brothers who are going to become members of gang and ultimately graduate to dealing drugs. We've got to get working families back into public housing, and we've got to get more male and female heads of household. We're taking that first step by establishing these market rent ceilings so that we don't penalize people for pulling themselves up by their bootstraps. And what the other thing we're going to have to do is we're going to have to make sure that we encourage people to work and to prosper and to save and to want to own their own home or to improve their lives.
Okay.
That's interesting.
Vince,
let me make this observation. If you succeed in doing that, my heart is with you. But I think if you think you can get working families back into Chicago housing, it apparently has not occurred to you that if you just look south to Gary, all those steel mills, all those industries are gone. 4 years of the Reagan administration, 4 years of the Reagan administration, 2 years of the Bush administration, they've sold all those jobs to Korea, to South America, to the Japanese.
Ed, see me next year at this time, Ed, and I'll walk you through a developer that will do that.
By anything that you can do in Chicago.
See me next year, Ed. See me next year, Ed.
General, in Chicago and Washington, my pleasure.
Ed, thank you very much. Vince, thank you very much. Frank, thanks very much for joining us. We'll take a break, and we're going to be back with a look at an environmental group which may have turned violent.